I was married before when I was 20.
Hey, how you doing?
Good.
Did you have a good time at Dad's?
Yes.
Good.
My ex-wife, Tanya, and I, we do get along, and we do have that relationship because of the boys.
I think Dad and I need to talk for a minute. Do you guys want to go out back with Wally?
Tanya is going to be a very huge part of Aya and my life. I'm getting ready to go next week to finally get Aya. Whatever day we get back, we will have 90 days to still decide if we want to get married. And if we don't get married within those 90 days, then she's supposed to have to go back.
You sure you want to marry her?
Yes.
So how exactly did you meet?
We met on an online dating site.
Why did she want to get out of the Philippines so badly?
She didn't want to leave the Philippines. If I didn't have the boys, I would be moving there.
Then why the international dating site?
Unfortunately, you hear, and even Aya will tell you, there are girls from the Philippines all the time that are with guys for completely the wrong reasons. Tanya doesn't want me to get hurt.
Anybody that I've mentioned this situation to finds it highly unusual. I really try not to give them much information. I just say, yes, he's getting married. Yes, she's from the Philippines. One question I have, is she a mail order bride? What makes this different?
To my understanding, mail order brides, they actually pay a site or what would be considered a marriage broker to basically find them a girl.
Well, that may be the technical definition, but I think
you're not letting me finish.
Here in this country, when people say that, it's kind of a blanket statement to cover, like, not only did you pay for it, but is she just coming over here for the visa?
Well, and that's due to a lot of people's ignorance to what the whole thing entails. Direct them to me.
He just got defensive about it. Reacting that way to me asking that question, that did put a little doubt in my mind. Does she have any children?
No, she doesn't have any kids.
Okay, does she want children?
She does want to have kids. We're very careful about the boys and who they stay with. I can completely understand. She doesn't know Aya. I would be worried about the boys staying alone with somebody that I hadn't met.
Before the boys spend any time with her, I really feel like I need to meet her, because as far as I know, she's a stranger.
Nothing matters more to me than making sure those boys are okay.
I just hope that it doesn't have ill effects on my children.
If she gets here and the boys just absolutely hate her or she's not good to the boys, then I'm not just gonna marry her just because.
I have to meet, like, the whole family. Of course, I'm super nervous. They like me now, but they never talked to me, actually, so I don't know. We'll see what's gonna happen.
Welcome to the parents' house.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Mom, Dan, Aziza, Amy.
Hi.
Hi,
Mike. Thank you.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
Thank you. Hi.
Hi.
I see. Oh, there's so many people here.
Yeah.
Oh, cool. This is so nice.
Hi, Amy.
Hi.
He's
hey, easy, buddy.
That's Maisie. So you guys hungry?
I'm starving.
Aziza probably already ate today. Did you eat?
No, actually. Thank you. That was nice.
Is he by you?
No, sleep.
So, sweetie, do you want a bun, or you need a hamburger, or?
What's bun?
Bread.
No.
Chicken?
Plate?
Yeah.
Chicken, hamburger, whatever you want.
No, I don't want hamburger, thanks.
Your plate?
Good, don't worry about me.
You need to eat, because you have to get fat like all the rest of the American women.
No, thank you.
There's forks.
Yeah.
Right here.
Okay.
Put one there.
Thank you.
Right here.
Yeah, you want some chicken?
Chicken with this thing.
There's knives. We need anything else? Corn?
No, thank you. I'm good, okay. Really. Don't worry about me.
I know you guys are so busy running around. I want to make sure you eat.
Lizzie's just told me a million times that she doesn't like going out to eat. She doesn't like when people watch her eat. She has no problem with me seeing her eat. It's just mostly strangers or people she doesn't know well. I guess just some kind of little phobia. Okay.
She looks like she don't like my food.
No, please don't feed that. I just like your hug. It's so nice here. Just curious about everything.
I don't know what the custom is in Russia. If they would prepare a big meal and then somebody came and just sat there and wouldn't eat anything, I don't know. Anywhere that I've ever been, even if I don't like what somebody made, or if I wasn't hungry, I would take something.
So, yeah.
I'm not doing it on purpose. It's not, I don't know, it's just something I can't control.
There's a lot of preparing food, and then she didn't eat. So I kind of felt uncomfortable, all of us eating, and she wasn't eating. It made me uncomfortable. Talk.
Yeah, but I ain't saying it.
Why? Say it.
No, everything's good. Everything, it couldn't be better.